Hello and welcome back to Scale Me Down. And in this episode, we're going to build this beautiful laser-cut Fokker DR1 triplane kit from the Tony Ray range of model aeroplanes. Please like and subscribe to support the channel. And this kit was kindly supplied for review by Steve Webb Models, my local model shop. And in fact, that's the only place you can get one of these kits from. From the outset, I have to say the quality of the laser cut parts is exquisite. In the kit, you'll get these laser cut parts for making the machine guns, some hardware including the magnets and the tyres and such, some hinges, some 1mm carbon rod. This part was an amendment to the kit. And then, of course, the laser cut plywood and balsa components. Also included is some tissue for covering and some full-size plans to construct the wings. Instructions are a PDF download. And finally, some self-adhesive decals. On with the build. And the laser cutting means there's a minimum of mess, so we're going to work where it's warm and well lit here on the dining room table. Well, that's the wings largely done and a lovely bit of traditional building. I just thought I'd stop and show you how we got here. So I've been using this artist's foam board to build on, as it's nice and flat and it's easy to push pins in. However, I've had to push the pins into the side of the parts to avoid splitting the balsa wood, so the parts are very small and delicate. I've also protected the plans in cling film so that they don't stick once the glue cures and we can remove the parts from the board. The glue I've been using is this superphatic aliphatic resin from Deluxe Materials. Another good choice might be thin CA after we've slotted the parts together dry, but I prefer this superphatic as it gives you a bit of time to accurately position the parts. Now, onto the fuselage. That is the majority of the build and the basic structure completed, and it sat here next to my SE-5A, also from the Tony Ray range of model aircraft that we completed in a previous video on the channel. With all its laser cut, fretted out ribs and such, it's really pretty and it's almost a shame to cover it. But of course, it's necessary to cover it if we want it to fly. Now, the order in which we install the electronics, cover and assemble the model is critical so that we have access as we go along. It's quite an enjoyable build as the parts fit quite well. And here we have the result of around 10 hours work spread over 2 days. I kept the instructions as best I could, and the only thing really I modified were these additional Warren girder style stiffeners in the fuselage. Just on that note, the instructions are quite clear as they are a step-by-step photo montage. However, you'll notice there's no words. This makes subtly different parts quite difficult to identify. But what they're missing is a key to where the various parts are on the various sprues of plywood and balsa. For the covering, I've always wanted to do a German aeroplane in the lozenge style camouflage pattern. And so to achieve that, what we did was took some of the covering from the kit and I taped it down to a sheet of A4 paper with masking tape and then put it through our printer. And I found the pattern in an article by Bill Brown on the Free Flight Scale website. Now we can free our printed tissue by cutting around the edges of the sheet, and then I further cut these parts down to slightly oversized patches to cover each airframe part. I then dampen the tissue using this perfume atomizer bottle I bought from the supermarket, and it's filled with plain tap water. The idea being just to dampen the tissue, not soak it through. To fasten it down to the structure, I used this Deluxe Materials tissue paste. And then smooth all the parts out with the tissue paste glued to the structure nice and flat, and pinned it down to our artist foam board. And that's because as the moisture evaporates from the tissue, it shrinks tight. And that was to keep the parts nice and flat and warp free. Then, the next step was to use this Deluxe Materials Easy Dope. And I mixed this with 3 parts water to 1 part dope, and I applied it through the airbrush in a couple of thin coats. The advantage of this is there's no smell, it's water soluble, and it seals and shrinks the tissue tighter still. Time for final assembly, and the order of operations matters here. Before we can install the upper wing, or indeed this decking, we have to install and get the aileron servo working correctly. Now, unlike the SE5A, where this was embedded inside the wing structure with just the pushrod showing, this time the servo has to be mounted underneath the top wing out in the breeze. But at least there's some guidance this time on the instructions. Now that that's working, the remainder of the electronics and the rudder and elevator servos fasten to this cleverly designed mount, which slides into the front of the model and screws into position. There's then a hatch fastened by magnets underneath to access and connect up these servos. The cowling then fastens with magnets. Now time to finish up the final install. We can connect up the rudder and elevator servos with the supplied 1mm carbon rod. Screw the electronics mount into place. These are the machine guns from the kit, all finished and painted, and also a 3D print of me as the pilot. I made and applied these water slide decals rather than the kit supplied self-adhesive ones, as they're a bit easier to deal with. So here we are with her all finished, ready for flight, and what a gorgeous little model. All finished, the all-up weight is 46 grams, and that includes the radio gear and the flight battery. I would put this kit at the intermediate to advanced skill level, as parts of it are quite fiddly and challenging, although it could be made quite a bit easier with the inclusion of a key that shows you where the various parts are on the sheets of wood. It can be constructed with just some glue and some simple tools. Everything else you require is in the kit. And a big thanks to Steve Webb Models for providing this kit for us to review, and I'll put a link to their website in the description below. What we need now is a totally flat, calm day to perform a test flight, so that will have to wait, I'm afraid. But stay tuned to the channel by subscribing and pressing the bell icon for notifications of updates. Thanks for watching.